why I am no longer a libertarian. Well, people have asked me my politics. One video I kind of said I'm a paleo-conservative, liberty-oriented nationalist, which probably is true. Nationalist is a good term for my country and my people. But I have referred to myself as a libertarian for many years. I forgot what the video was about right there. I'm getting old, folks. It's going. But I have referred to myself as a libertarian. I was. But I never joined the Libertarian Party. I actually went to their website when I was much younger and thought about joining. But looking at a lot of planks in their politics, I just couldn't really quite support that. You know. And the Libertarian Party, you know, is quite frankly just as insane as the Democrats or Republicans, or as the Democrats in here. Some Republicans aren't quite so insane. And they're insane for two reasons. First of all, they support open borders. It's completely insane. If you want to have a country, you can't have open borders. You know, open borders, supporting open borders is exactly what the puppet masters want, to destroy and destabilize their country. And I realize that now, how important that is. It's bothered me my entire life. For 40 years and more, I've been saying, let's close the borders to friends and family. You know, didn't have a YouTube channel at that time, of course. But now I see how far it's gone. They're destabilizing and wrecking our country. They're destroying Europe again. Put Muslims in Europe. It's not just about Muslims. But that's an effort to destabilize Europe and destroy Europe and destroy Western society. And they're doing it. These people have an agenda. They have lots and lots of money. People like George Soros, and there's lots of other ones who are doing this on purpose for their own purposes. They're not doing it because they believe in Marxism. They don't believe in multiculturalism. They don't believe in diversity. They're doing it to destabilize the country. And so the Libertarian Party, you know, going for open borders, it's just completely insane. It's a joke. The other thing with the Libertarian Party and the Democratic Party, and to some degree the mostly the Republican Party, is the belief in the egalitarian delusion, which I'll make a video about one of these days. No, people are not all the same. And the egalitarian delusion is what allows people mentally to bring in millions of Mexicans here, and millions of Sub-Saharan Africans, and millions of Muslims here who aren't going to live the same way we live, and aren't going to want to have the same kind of country we want to have. The fact is, Mexicans and Sub-Saharan Africans and Muslims and all these other people are overwhelmingly going to vote for Marxist, neo-Marxist, democratic, socialist ideas, which are ruining the country. And that's the whole purpose of doing this, to destroy the country and create, you know, divisiveness, not diversity, but divisiveness. And so I can no longer support even the word libertarianism. I'm for liberty and freedom. But those liberties and freedom we talk about weren't created by Mexicans, they weren't created by Muslims, they weren't created by Sub-Saharan Africans. Those ideas of liberty and equality were created by Europeans in Europe. That's where those ideas come from. Our people, my people. I'm sorry, politically, I mean, it's just true. And when you import a bunch of people in the country who don't think that way, and they just don't think that way. If you look at K/R political philosophy on YouTube, it's all about genetics and K/R selection for genetics, and how people who are selected, how they think. All the people that are importing from these other countries, these are R selected countries. And they think in an R selected way. Look it up to see what I'm talking about. You know, and that's why they're importing them. Because they don't think like K selected people think. And that is ruining the country. So, and as far as libertarians go, I'll speak to all you libertarians directly. I used to think of myself as one of you. You know. That philosophy of A, open borders, and B, egalitarianism, guarantees libertarianism will die. The Libertarian Party will become nothing. It will eventually die. Because the people they're importing don't care about liberty and freedom. I know individuals, some of them might, but overwhelmingly they don't. They don't care about liberty or freedom or altruism. They care about power and getting what they can get from our country. The fact you've got Mexicans down at Trump rallies beating Trump supporters, and blocking the doors so Trump can get into his own rallies, and flying Mexican flags and burning American flags tells you that right there. That says it all in a lot of ways. I'm not saying all Mexicans or all Mexican Americans are like that. We're talking about percentages of the population here, though, in general. So I can't support the Libertarian Party. I can't support Libertarians. I probably won't vote Libertarian again unless it's against a Democrat. I'll have to vote Republican because at least they sometimes talk a good game. That's why I'll vote for Trump. Even though I'm not sure even that all that will help. What this country probably needs is a revolution or a military coup by people who think like I do. Probably won't happen. We're probably just going to go down the damn tubes. We don't have much longer before we're going to go down the down tubes one way or the other. That's why I'm no longer a libertarian. I believe in liberty and freedom and a lot of those principles, but within the framework of a country. Liberty and freedom for people in that country. Not, and that doesn't include having open borders, bring anybody who wants to come here. I believe in liberty and freedom in my own household. You know, people can speak their minds, have opinions, do their thing. But I don't believe people can break into my house and start eating my food and demand medical care from me. No, I don't. I don't want people of bizarre, violent religions coming in my house and setting up shop. No, I don't. I don't want them coming to my country either. I just don't. And that's why I'm no longer a libertarian. Next up, why I'm no longer a Republican. I never have been a Republican, but the Libertarian Party's policies in this way, the egalitarian delusion that they traffic in, and the immigration, open borders nonsense, they are guaranteed become less and less of an anything. You're guaranteed, if you're a libertarian, if you support those things, that your ideas about liberty and freedom and all those things will cease to exist. They will never exist in this country. They're about gone now as it is. You're guaranteeing your own demise with those policies. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching. Again, I would appreciate it if you go to my Patreon and support my channel. If you want to see more videos like this, please do that. That will keep these videos coming. And please give me a thumbs up. That makes the video seen. And please share these videos with a friend so I can get more subscribers. That also encourages me to make videos. I never intend to have a YouTube channel. Never intend to make any more than about two videos about pipes in the beginning, but now I am. And that only happened because my first video, I got 100 views. I was shocked. I thought I'd get one view or two views, maybe. That's all it was about. But people kept watching the damn videos. They kept watching them, and to watch the fat guy smoke a pipe or a cigar, I guess, and that's what happened. And those things encourage me. So I also make these videos because I think people need to know what's going on. You need to see the reality of the world. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching. I appreciate you watching. I really do. And I do appreciate dissent as long as it's respectful dissent, not insulting dissent. I'll talk to you later.